let's talk about your board. This is really something else. You have to maximize your board. Many organizations start with a board of 3, 5, 7, or 9, and they get people who they trust, they know, and they can work with. That's wonderful. That's just to get you started. Once you get started and begin to operate, you want to do a matrix to see, okay, what kind of people do I have on my board? Based on the operation of like organizations, what kind of members do they have? How well do I match up? If everyone on your board is from church and maybe your school, but other organizations have that, plus they have lawyers, doctors, engineers, bankers, maybe a secretary from a big corporation. If they have that, that's a signal you better get the same thing. If you can't get those same people served on your board, get their peers to serve on your board. That's how you maximize your board. The new rules now of people who give money, they're looking to see how well you have maximized and diversified your board. So make sure you have men and women and maybe someone or two people who can represent your population. Otherwise, if you're saying you're serving abused women on your board, do you have anyone on your board who can represent the abused women? So this is very important. And they're going to be looking to see, what kind of flavors do you have? We're now moving, it's almost a kickback. Some people were mad because other folks had one flavor, but it has now been reversed. Well, some in our neighborhood only have one flavor on their board. If you want to get bigger money, more money, get it more often, maximize your board with male, female, and every ethnic person that will represent ethnic people in your area. This is very, very important.